Well, hello there again, my YouTube friends. On the bench today, I've got this product that I bought on the off chance that it might have been pretty good for hopefully cleaning circuit boards. Now, you probably know straight away what it is or what it looks like by the thing here. I'd never seen them before a few days ago, and I was just rooting around for, I don't know, I was actually looking for toothbrush, electric toothbrushes, thinking that it might be easier for doing maybe like iPhone boards, because I was doing an audio chip on an iPhone 7 the other day and cleaning the flux out of components that small can be a bit difficult sometimes. So I was looking for various ideas on how to go about making that easier for myself. So normally what I use is this heat modified toothbrush. So I can just sort of, go round like that and, clean, stuff. I used to use this. This can actually go in the bin now. This has been used for probably a year or two now. And the bristles are starting to fall out of it. It's supposedly an ESD brush. So I was just looking for another thing. So I bought this thing that I saw on Amazon, and it's for obviously a kitchen cleaner. That's the idea of it. And then when I saw this little brush on it, I thought, that looks like maybe circuit board size. So along with this little fella, I bought these as well, which all connect just like the toothbrushes you see for your teeth, really. But this is on a slightly bigger scale, and they come with spare. Actually, this comes on its own. You have to buy these separately. And I was thinking to myself, well, I want, that's the actual brush I want. So, I mean, these could be useful. You can see they go into like a little point there. I've actually opened this one. I think I have, yeah. So these are like a pointed thing. So they probably would be good for, doing, PCBs. If you only had a small, that might even be good for, the iPhone thing that I was looking for. But I'm looking at this one really. So what we're going to do is we're going to try it today. I got this off I think I mentioned Amazon. I just saw it and thought it was I think was it 13 12 or 13 pound for this thing, and I thought I'll have a go of it. I've had it out the box already, just to see what it sounded like and everything. And you even get a little, it's quite a weighty thing. Obviously it's got four batteries in it. Comes with batteries, safe energy type batteries. I've checked them, they're not leaking or anything like that, so I will use them up and perhaps put some rechargeables in it in future. But I'll turn it on so you can hear it. It is quite noisy compared to a like a toothbrush. It's quite noisy, but the size of it, it's bigger than a toothbrush, and it does it is an oscillating one as well. So you've got the on button. You can turn it on just for brief periods, or you can just turn it on and leave it on like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use it in a real world test. So it's the Sonic Scrubber, and I'll put prices up. I'll put the link to Amazon underneath, just in case anyone wants to get one of these, assuming that it actually does the job that I want it to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that to one side, and I've got this, what looks like, I think it's an old PC board. It might be off a server or something like that. I actually don't know. I have no idea where this board came from. It's just in a pile of boards I've got in the back room there in a big tub. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some hot air in this region with a load of flux, and I'm going to burn the flux in. I'm going to use the 559 flux because it's a bit more tacky than the 213. I'm still using the 213A as my normal daily flux, and it seems to be pretty good. I did the audio IC, as I say before, on an iPhone 7, and it was fine. Pretty easy to clean off, but it might have been even easier had I had one of these little fellas. So let's whip a couple of these ICs off and put them back on, and I'll do it like a proper video. We'll go under the microscope and everything, and make a little test out of it. One thing I forgot to mention, guys, is I paid a bit more for this one because it had the Sonic Scrubber logo and everything on it. I've seen these that look very similar online, cheaper, but I wasn't sure, you know, what the quality of those ones would be like. And I noticed that when I was reading the info about them, that the other types only had the head oscillation was only 8,000 oscillations per minute. This is 10,000. Now, whether that's just a printing discrepancy and they are all actually the same device, I don't know, because there's quite a difference in price. The Sonic brush on its own was $14.99, and the brush pack was $7.49, the little three pack of brushes. But I later found out that on because I was looking for just this tip, you can't actually buy them separate, I don't think. You have to buy them in the packet of these, like this, and there's various ones of these online. There is a four pack that contains this one, but it's over in the States and I couldn't find anyone over here who supplied it. But I went to the Sonic Scrubbers proper website and they actually have all these in and you can buy them separately. So I bought another three of these, which cost £10 for three. So I'm just hoping I haven't wasted me money, and when these are dipped in flux, they don't just dissolve or something. Hopefully not. They feel like toothbrush bristles, so hopefully they should be all right. So yeah, just before I move on, these just, as it says, twist on and off, and you just basically, just like a toothbrush again. I keep putting it on, expecting it to be there, but it's not. It goes 180 degrees out, so the actual way it goes on is that way, and twist, and then it locks into that position. So what I'll do, now I'm here, I'll put this one on. Oh, he looks much better with that end on him. Okay, let's do a bit of rework, so to speak. Unnecessary rework, but necessary for my video. Okay guys, so I've got this little fella mounted on here, and I'm going to get some 559 and soak these two soy packages in flux, and then we'll stick the hot air on and make a mess on this board. Just wait for the hot air to get up to temp. So I'll just whip these off, and we don't mind if the flux gets burned, because that's the idea of this video, just to see if our new, hopefully handy dandy little tool works. These are probably ready to come off now, but I want to burn the flux if I can. Okay, so give him some more heat. Start to go brown now in some areas, this flux, so that's what we want. And we'll just put these little fellows back on. In fact, we'll get some more flux on the go first, eh? Actually makes a nice change to be putting some components on that I can actually see properly. Doesn't even matter if they're the wrong way round, it's only a scrap board, so. Okay, so just melt the everything's floating now. Okay, so that should be nice and sticky, that board. Okay, so here we are back under this camera. So I'm going to put my other soldering iron on, and I'm going to give this a bit of a burn with the soldering iron as well, just so it's like real life, really. So it'll be a good test. Not even doing any soldering, really, just burning it. So we leave some dirty residue there from the soldering iron. And see, it's the flux is really burning now. It's going brown, so it's getting burnt off. Okay, so I think that'll do for our little nasty area. Okay, so my normal procedure was to basically get the toothbrush with a bit of IPA on, or flux cleaner, and you know, just clean around a little bit. I've started using I was just using IPA up until maybe about 6 months ago, but I started having problems, especially on the iPhones, just decant it into these little tubes. And I started using Flux Clean, which I have good results with. I had to replace it last week. It lasts about, the shelf life is about, let's see, it's about 3 years, I think. It lasts a long time, or 2 years. So I've just got a new one of these. These are like £22, £24, I think, for a litre. But it lasts me ages. If you're decanting it into one of these, it lasts a long time. So over that sort of period, it doesn't actually work out as costing too much. But I find that you saw me using it the other day when I was doing the iPod port repair. This stuff actually seems a lot stronger than just IPA. So now we are pretty cool now, and the board's the board's all tacky and horrible. So that's what we were actually after. Now, I'm not going to do this. Is not a if a board was minging, what I'd do is I'd just bung it in the ultrasonic. But this is just for, you know, sort of local small cleaning jobs where you need it to clean and you don't actually want to, you know, put it in the ultrasonic for, you know, 6 minutes. So we've got our handy dandy little new thing here, and what I think I want to do is pull this off, because I can picture me dragging things off the bench with this. Much better. And you just stand up just like that, so there's no problem there. Okay, so let's bung some Flux Clean on this. I'll zoom you guys in. Oop, not that close, and I think that's as close as I can get without going out of focus. So I'm going to shall I use the Flux Clean or shall I just use IPA? Because the Flux Clean is going to take that off pretty good. So just to try it first, I'm just going to use IPA, and I need that to be pretty level so it doesn't run off all over the show. Okay, so sorry about the noise, guys. This is the new tool being put into action. So straight away, I can see that it's making quite a mess of splattering stuff all over me table. So it's not splashing it real far, but you need to be aware that it does splash stuff around because it's obviously flicking it as it's oscillating. But it is getting rid of a lot of the built up flux that's stuck between the legs of components. You can see that it has cleared the area up quite neat. So what I'll do is, I'll just give it some Flux Clean as well. And I'll just put a cloth around it so it's not flicking it everywhere as much. Okay, so the bristles haven't melted. They're still reasonably stiff. You can get, I think, a softer brush than this. So if you feel a softer brush is necessary, you know, that might be necessary because they are quite, they're not super, you know, stiff, but it does say there's a stiff brush, but the stiff brush is only available in a different type. I think this comes as a medium, but I think there is a soft brush as well, but I'm not 100% sure of that. So now we need to dry this board off, and let's see if we can do it also the usual way. It's actually destroying the tissue there, but if you press lighter, it's actually okay. There is still bits of flux residue knocking around. But I think it's definitely better than doing it with a scrubbing brush. So I'm going to keep using this and just see, you know, how long I have to do this for to get it, you know, pretty clean. Okay, let's give it another go. I'm just using the edge of the brush now. And I'm not pressing very hard either. It's basically just the weight of the brush itself. Actually, it does look pretty clean. You see, it's quite lean there, quite clean there. So I think I'm gonna like that, guys. Especially for really dense boards like you know, these iPhone boards. The only problem I can foresee with these is that the bristles on this tool are actually possibly wider than the gaps between the components. Now, whether the ultrasonic sort of washing pressure movement in the fluid will actually help, you know, between the components remains to be seen. Let's just see what it feels like. And now I'm just looking at the bristle size compared to toothbrush size. Yeah, the toothbrush bristles are quite a bit finer. Anyway, I'm still going to use it. I still think it's a good addition to the cleaning equipment for the bench here. And of course, as I said, I've still got the, you know, if you need to do a large area on a larger board, you can just use, you know, the bigger brush. These bristles actually feel softer. Whether it's just because there's many of them, I don't know. Perhaps it would have been better using that on this area because this is quite a big board. Let's see what that one feels like. Yeah, it feels a little bit softer, that one, I think. Might just be psychological, though. Yeah, because they are, I was going to say tightly more packed, but I don't think they are. They just definitely feel a bit softer, those ones. And as I say, they do different brush toughnesses. Okay, that is the Sonic scrubber, guys, and it's available from Amazon. if you're interested. As I say, I paid for this. I just bought it, you know, just for, you know, interest in doing this particular job, and it seems to work pretty well. It's at least as good as a, you know, using a toothbrush. There is actually flux up here. Now, I haven't done anything to this board up here. I haven't done anything to this board full stop. As I say, it's just a scrap board, but there is flux and dirt and crud up in this area. So I'm going to use my new tool, guys, and see how it feels against this stuff, or how it does. I'll just zoom you in so you can see the dirtiness of that area. No, can you? You can now. So I'll just put a bit of flux clean on there. And that was baked on flux there. So yeah, and you can see that is actually much cleaner straight away. And that that's been baked on for probably a few years, that whatever that was there. So let's try it over here in this area. I think that is burnt on stuff there. Let me just double check. Just press a little bit harder. Now, whatever that is, it's stuck on there real good. Yeah, it's doing a nice job, guys. So that's the Sonic Scrubber power cleaning system, as it says on the unit itself, guys. Seems like a a handy little tool to have. I was using it on the corner or the grooves in one of the Allsop mouse mats last night when I just first tried to try it out for the first time, and I got all sorts of crud out of there. I mean, the mouse mats do get cleaned with anti-back and all that, but the little grooves at the bottom, all dust and all sorts of grime gets in there, and that was great for getting all that stuff out. So it's not just for, you know, the thing, you know, I'm using it for in the video. You can use it for all sorts of stuff. So yeah, that's it, guys. I'll say thanks for watching the video, and I shall see you in the next one. Thanks, guys. Take care.